long-standing tradition continues for Torrance as it makes its 64th entry in the Rose Parade. And to add to its accolades, Torrance wins the Tournament Volunteer Trophy Award for having the most outstanding floral presentation of the Rose Parade this year.
I am very excited since we started at 10 o'clock last night, but we've actually been decorating all week. Yeah. So the day after Christmas up until the 30th. So I've been with the float for the entire week and then all night. So yeah, it's a lot of emotion, a lot of excitement just to see it go down the boulevard.
The Volunteer Award highlights that the float was assembled with the harmonious camaraderie of volunteers from ages 13 to 90. Families like Melissa's are true pillars of the community as they continue their own family tradition to come every year and be a part of the volunteer team.
Well, for me, it's kind of a legacy. My whole family decorates. There's two generations working on the float during decorating week. So it's for us, it's a family event.
Torrance's float came together with over 5,000 flowers, 2,000 of them being pink roses to offset the green backdrop, and then white and red carnations, purple status flowers, golden straw flowers, yellow and green arrangements, and a lush trim of green garland, pine, water leaves, and huckleberry. The artist behind the float's creation this year was junior Justin Kim from West High School. It was the theme of music that inspired him to enter the contest in the first place, because music means so much to him.
Ever since I was a little kid, I've done music-related things. I've learned the instruments, multiple instruments like piano and guitar, flutes, and all sorts of instruments.
Wow.
So it really connects to me.
Justin helped with making the little ornament pieces like these music notes. He mostly appreciated how the float was decorated with all natural ingredients, like crushed rice, coconut, poppy seeds, flax seeds, and everything that's black on the float is covered in seaweed. And to top it all off, the float added a live band at the hem to bring the Torrance Float Association's vision to life.
Now, we've been hearing a lot of music in the parade so far. I mean, there's been marching bands and wind ensembles and music coming through the stereos for the Color Garden dancers to dance to. But no float is like the Torrance Float in that we have the only live rock band performing on set. And the great thing is that this is Torrance's 130th entry for the Rose Parade. I think Torrance has set a new standard and raised the bar for special attractions on floats in the Rose Parade this year.
Torrance's float was 14th in the lineup and traveled down Colorado Boulevard behind this year's Grand Marshal, Chaka Khan. The float also included riders like the ladies from the Rose Float Association. Tammy Resnack is one of the members, and she looks forward to being a part of this tradition every year.
To be here part of that, you know, part of all those years is just an honor. So we're thrilled. It's going to be amazing when we turn the corner on Colorado Boulevard and see all these people, you know, yelling and cheering for our float and our riders.
Float riders waved with genuine smiles, and Alinea got the crowds on their feet, jumping and dancing as Torrance's float passed by. With the melody of life being this year's theme, goers of the parade took time to reflect on what that means to them in light of the new year.
The highs and the lows and just how it all blends together in harmony and brings everybody together, all the cultures together, all the different people from different parts of the world, and it's all one song.
Reporting from the 2019 Rose Parade, I'm Danny Miskell for This Week in Torrance.